Fundamentals of software testing, different business, different testing, different software layer, different issues. So let's talk about a bit software business, what kind of a software business there are. So far we have been talking about how to test, but there are so many different ways of testing related to business model and software layers and such. So what are the differences of testing if you are testing a commercial off-the-shelf product such as Microsoft Excel or some computer game that can be bought from store versus software that is used only inside of an organization or in one place only, such as International Space Station? There is some kind of a life support system in space that it exists only in the space station. There is no real use case in Earth for such software. So when there is only one existing instance versus 1,000 or 1,000,000 existing instances of the software, then also the testing is a bit different. So to test Excel, it is much different than testing rocket engine software. But how? So we can clearly state that they are different. But for example, if you are talking about International Space Station, then the test force is much smaller because I myself cannot test the software, I don't have it. I cannot be in the actual environment to test it. But if I'm using Excel or some kind of a text editor or code editor, there are millions of users for those software and they can test it. While they are not professional testers, they can still use it and test it. For example, these kind of issues one has to note. And also one interesting point is that testing an open source project is very different from proprietary software. So testing Microsoft Office Excel is different than testing LibreOffice spreadsheet. And if you are testing computer games, it's different than testing a paper mill production management software. We can divide software businesses and softwares to pieces of software to different categories. Here is one way to divide it. In the Y axis there is a license, and in the X axis there is this layer based division. So we have a proprietary software. Source code is not released and you probably have to pay money for the use of software. And then there are freeware that can be used, but the source code is not released. And then there is open source where source code is released and you don't have to pay anything. And in the layer, there is this bottom, we have a hardware layer, then there is operating system, application, software, and then user space. So testing can be done in any cases, but it's different if you are testing software that lies inside hardware and proprietary software. And then if we have a, let's say, open source game here, these are very different. If we think about a few examples, for example, a proprietary software in a hardware, AMD Ryzen processor, there is a lot of code inside that processor and it's not released open source. It's hard to test. If I wanted to test it, I cannot do it. Then if we think about some kind of a free not open source. Application software, Opera browser is good example. And if you are in a user space, that means that a user is doing something with the software itself and producing something there. He or she could create some email filters. And if we consider those email filter settings as a piece of software, it is probably free if we are using it by ourselves, and we can of course give them out as an open source, but then there needs to be some kind of a license related to that personal email filter. And proprietary software, application software, Excel, good example, operating system that is not free, Windows 10. Open source hardware, although this is in a way it's a new topic, but we now have some examples of hardware that are open source, like Arduino. But 20 years ago there wasn't really any hardware opened. Open source operating system, for example Fedora Linux, and open source application software, 0AD game, and user space, we can have a document template for Excel or Word, application proprietary StarCraft game, and some kind of a free besides Opera, Foxit Reader, PDF Reader is a good example, and open source mail client Thunderbird is a one. I really couldn't get anything here, but if you can Google enough, then you can find something to those parts too. So testing these, there are like 12 different areas. It's very, very different if you are testing Fedora Linux or then you are testing StarCraft. You have a source code here, you can use it. You cannot use source code if you are outside of Blizzard and you want to find some kind of a bug. Maybe it's a bug, you would like to test it further, but you cannot do it anything else but black box testing. So testing well, although random users should probably not be considered as a tester, many software providers accept bug reports from the user. So if you are just playing a game, you don't have access to its source code, but you like playing it and you find that there is some problem within the game, it's probably a bug, and you can report it to the company that is creating that game. So they are getting test reports from players, gamers, and then they are improving the product through those reports. But then again, they have a real testing group inside the company, and that testing group might have access to the source code. So there are outside testers and inside testers. If the proper code is proprietary. So with open source gaming, you of course have the option to have a source code. Yeah, so you can do only black box testing if you don't have the source code. This is probably the use case in 99% of the tasks when just some customer or user is testing a program. So with open source software there is an option also to do white box testing, but who does it? I haven't read the Firefox source code ever, although it's available if I want to read it, but I haven't. So there is an option, but most of the users never do white box testing. They even don't know the the concept of white box testing because they haven't been in this course. But now, as you have been in this course, you know what is white box testing and what is black box testing and how you can do white box testing with open source project, but you cannot do it with closed source. But then again, there are those persons that want to check the code. They go and download the Firefox source code and they read it, they find bugs, they report it, they can even improve the code. Hacking spirit. So there was this four layers, hardware layer, operating system, application software layer and user space. When bug is found in the upper layers, tester cannot be certain whether the bug exists in the software being tested or in some other layers. So if we are talking about open source project or we are otherwise doing white box testing, then the bug can be found from the software that is being tested. But if it's not found or you are doing black box testing, you really cannot be certain if the bug exists in the software itself, or is it in operating system, or is it even hardware. So for example, you are doing something with MATLAB and the MATLAB calculation seems to be a bit off. Then you can check your own code, as in the user space your own code is there, MATLAB code, and it seems that no, this code is okay, there should be no bugs. Then you check the application layer, MATLAB itself. Is there some problem with MATLAB function? Maybe in some kind of a function library there is a bug. Or is it even an operating system? You're running it in Windows 10 and there is some kind of a bug that produces error in MATLAB that's then again produce error in your code. Or is there even a hardware bug that the processor itself is calculating wrong, or the graphics card? We had this this video describing this Intel Pentium bug. So it can be even hardware. So then the tester has to be really certain that the bug is not in his or her own code, but it's somewhere else. And how do you fix the bug that is not in your control? It's somewhere else. That is one question that the tester needs to be aware, although the fixing part is then someone else's job. But of course you can report the bug further if you find it that it's not your code, it's someone else's code, then you report it to that part. About a little bit about the computer games, if we compare a word processor and computer game, so then the testing is a bit different. There are some that basically the same parts exist, but the emphases are different. So with computer game, the user experience testing is much more important than with the word processor or some kind of a calculating software. And this is also true with very many other things than just games. So games need to be fun to play. Digital signature needs to be secure. Mobile bank app needs to be easy to use. CAD tool needs to have a lot of functional features. And startup needs to build business model generating money for them. So in every case, these testing things, they are emphasized differently. Of course, if we are talking about mobile bank app, it needs to be secure, it needs to be usability needs to be good. Probably there are a lot of functional features that needs to be tested and the user experience needs to be great. But then again, easy to use is something that if you have a lot of mobile bank apps in your phone, you choose the one that is the most easy to use. And of course, testing itself, if you are doing testing with games, it can be fun because you are basically running the game and playing. And if you are yes, you are some kind of an indie tester and you find issues with games, you can also start your own YouTube channel and you can make videos about those testing sessions and show people how you can find strange things from games. As a conclusion, emphasizing different testing areas is strongly depending on software business area and level of software, where is it running. So working with different software layers requires different testing focuses, and this means that the software tester can focus or specialize themselves to various testing areas. Basically, only the sky is the limit. If you want to test games, you can decide that okay, you are doing user experience testing. If you are interested in security testing, you can still test games also, but then the focus is it's much more lower parts of the game. It's not in the user experience, but in the more in the unit testing level, where all those game communications with servers and other services, then those are tested. Testing can be fun and profitable.